I've been looking for you. Got something I'm supposed to deliver. Your hands only. Let's see here. There's a new lady in charge of the orphanage in Riften. She asked me to hand out these notices to everyone I met. Looks like that's it. Got to go.
Sorry, I'm afraid I can't help you much right now. I'm currently in mourning.
Never seen me old.
Never done an honest day's work in your life for all that coin you're carrying, eh, lass? I'm saying you've got the coin, but you didn't earn a septim of it honestly. I can tell. It's all about sizing up your mark, lass. The way they walk, what they're wearing. It's a dead giveaway. Look how you sniffed out my little scheme at the North Gate. You knew it was a shakedown, and you called him on it. That's what I'm talking about. Wealth is my business. Help me out, and I can add to yours. Would you like a taste? I've got a bit of an errand to perform, but I need an extra pair of hands. And in my line of work, extra hands are well paid. Simple. I'm going to cause a distraction. You're gonna steal Medesi's silver ring from a strongbox under his stand. Once you have it, I want you to place it in Branche's pocket without him noticing. There's someone that wants to see him put out of business permanently. That's all you need to know. You tell me when you're ready, and we'll get started. Do you want me to hold your hand as well? You're going to have to sneak over to Medesi's stall and use your lockpick on the strongbox. Then, when you have the ring, you pickpocket Branche and leave it behind. We've been contracted to make sure Branche remembers not to meddle in affairs that aren't his own. Now, since we're not the Dark Brotherhood, we're not going to kill him. We're just going to make sure he sits in the prisons for a few days. Get them before they're gone. Good. Wait until I start the distraction, then show me what you're made of.
Everyone, everyone, gather round. I have something amazing to show you that demands your attention. You need to hear this. This way, everyone. Over here.
Nope. What is it this
Sorry.
Time?
Nothing.
Patience, Branche. This is a rare opportunity, and I wouldn't want you to get left out.
That's what you said about... Wispesses.
Well,
get away from me.
Come back tomorrow if you wish to buy.
What a waste of time.
Can I interest you in some fine goods from Morrowind? I may be Dark Elf by birth, but I was raised Argonian. For reasons I'm still trying to discover, I ended up orphaned, then taken in by a kindly Argonian family in Black Marsh. I hope one day to find out what happened to me, how I ended up like that. Just one. I know when I was found by my Argonian father, I was wrapped in a blanket bearing the symbol of House Telvanni. It was one of the great houses in Morrowind long ago. Whether that means I was one of them or not, I'm uncertain. If you come across anything in your travels that might provide me with the answers I'm looking for, I'd be grateful. Thank you. I learned that a matron who had served for House Telvanni had escaped Morrowind during the Accession War. Records showed her buying passage for a settlement named the Pride of Telvos, but that's where the trail ran cold. I spent years looking for what became of the ship, but I ended up empty-handed. Anything.
Looks like I chose the right person for the job.
Good luck.
And here you go. Your payment. Just as I promised. The way things have been going around here, it's a relief that our plan went off without a hitch. Nah. My organization's been having a run of bad luck. But I suppose that's just how it goes. But never mind that. You did the job, and you did it well. Best of all, there's more where that came from. If you think you can handle it. All right then. Let's put that to the test. The group I represent has its home in the Ratway beneath Riften, a tavern called the Ragged Flagon. Get there in one piece, and we'll see if you've really got what it takes.
Beautiful baubles and gleaming gemstones.
Are
over.
I'm telling you, this one is different.
We've all heard that one before, Bryn. Quit kidding yourself. It's time to face the truth, old friend. You, Vex, Mercer, you're all part of a dying breed.
I think Brynjolf could give you all the information you need.
Well, what do you call that, then? Well, well. Color me impressed, lass. I wasn't certain I'd ever see you again. Reliable and headstrong? You're turning out to be quite the prize. So, now that I've whetted your appetite with our little scheme at the market, how about handling a few deadbeats for me? They owe our organization some serious coin, and they've decided not to pay. I want you to explain to them the error of their ways. Kirava, Bercy Honeyhand, and Helga. Do this right, and I can promise you a permanent place in our organization. Honestly, the debt is secondary here. What's more important is that you get the message across that we aren't to be ignored. A word of warning, though. I don't want any of them killed. Bad for business. Good. If you need any details on your marks, I'll be here. Now get going. I'll be here when you're done.
If you're looking for conversation, the flagon isn't the place. Stay alive?
Wait, I know you.
Fresh meats and produce. Get them before they're gone.
So, can I interest you in anything today?
What? Oh, it's one of you people.
So Brynjolf doesn't even bother to show up himself anymore, eh? What's this message? Petty threats and fist-waving are not going to sway me. You people are all talk, and everyone knows it. You demand payment for protection, and you can't even protect yourselves! Don't fool yourself. It's only a matter of time before you people are run out of Riften. I'm going to make you sorry for this. Come on! You're mine!
Why, Ysmir? You'll pay for that? Lucky hit!
You're here for friendlier reasons now. After all, I'm all paid up. I hope you're here.
If you're looking for a room in Private B and Bar, this place is for the working man. What did you want? What does he want now? I already explained to him that you can't get blood from a stone. Ha! We'll see about that.
Get her!
Oh no, you don't! It's nothing! And you thought I was just a pretty face.
12 septims on the big one. Come on, she's not so tough.
Here, take your damn coin and get out of here.
Sorry about the mess.
The Lavrifton! Heed my words.
Looking for work? I need someone to deliver a message to Sibyl.
This is one of the signs. Keep the signs that Lady Mara is displeased with your constant inebriation.
I presume you're bothering me for a good reason.
Put down your flagons filled with your vile liquids and embrace the teachings of the Handmaiden of Kine.
No, no, Marimal. We talked about this. Talon?
Kirava, certainly we can come to some sort of an understanding. These people must be made aware of the chaos they've sown.
Enough, Marimar. We've all heard of the dragons and their return. There's no need to use them as an excuse to harass customers.
What in the name of Oblivion do you want?
Very well, Talon. I'll remove myself from this den of iniquity.
We're not kicking you out. Just keep the sermons at the temple and let us all sin in peace.
Blessings of Mara upon you. Wonderful. Where to begin? Mara is the goddess of love. The temple spreads her gifts by tending to the sick, the poor, and the lost. We also perform wedding ceremonies for all the loving couples in Skyrim. Yes, if you were ready, of course. Are you familiar with how marriage works in Skyrim? Typically, love in Skyrim is as earnest as the people who live here. Life is hard and short, so there's little room for long courtship. A person who is looking for a spouse simply wears an amulet of Mara about the neck, showing they are available. When another person shows interest and the two agree to be together, one of them comes to the temple and we arrange a ceremony. Of course. I'd be more than happy to add a donation to our charity box. Right now, the best you could provide is coin. We need all the help we can get. Thank you. I can promise you that this will be put to good use. May you return to her benevolence in safety.
What's your problem?
You want something or not? Look, everything was all just a misunderstanding. I didn't mean to tell Brynjolf to go jump off the pier. You tell him I'm sorry, yes? Take this. Every single coin I owe is there. I swear it.
Visiting Riften? All are welcome at the Temple of Mara.
Stay out of trouble, or there's gonna be trouble.
So, job's done and you even brought the gold. Best of all, you did it clean. I like that. Dumping bodies and keeping the guards quiet can be expensive.
Well done.
And it would seem I owe you something in return. Here you go. I think you'll find these quite useful. Judging from how well you've handled those shopkeepers, I'd say you've done more than simply prove yourself. We need people like you in our outfit. That's the spirit. Larceny's in your blood. The telltale sign of a practiced thief. I think you'll do more than just fit in around here. What's on your mind? We've run into a rough patch lately, but it's nothing to be concerned about. Tell you what, you keep making us coin. And I'll worry about everything else. Fair enough? Now, if there are no more questions, how about following me and I'll show you what we're all about?
And if you're one of us, you better not make
trouble.
Let
me show you the operation. Then you can ask your questions.
I don't care if you're best buddies with the Guildmaster. I'll still smash in your skull if you try anything.
wait until Brynjolf's here before we begin.
Mercer, this is the one I was talking about. Our new recruit.
This better not be another waste of the Guild's resources, Brynjolf. Before we continue, I want to make one thing perfectly clear. If you play by the rules, you walk away rich. You break the rules and you lose your share. No debates, no discussions. Do what we say, when we say. Do I make myself clear? Good, then I think it's time we put your expertise to the test.
Wait a moment. You're not talking about Golden Glow, are you? Even our little Vex couldn't get in.
You claim this recruit possesses an aptitude for our line of work. So let her prove it. Golden Glow Estate is critically important to one of our largest clients. However, the owner has suddenly decided to take matters into his own hands.
I suggest you listen to what Mercer has to say.
He needs to be taught a lesson. Brynjolf will provide you with the details.
Mercer, aren't you forgetting something?
Yes. Since Brynjolf assures me you'll be nothing but a benefit to us, then you're in. Welcome to the Thieves Guild.
Welcome to the family, lass. I'm expecting you to make us a lot of coin, so don't disappoint me. Simple. Do as you're told and keep your blade clean. We can't turn a profit by killing. You should talk with Delvin Mallory and Vex. They know their way around this place, and they'll be able to kick some extra jobs your way. Oh, and talk to Tonelia in the flagon. She'll set you up with your new armor. Golden Glow Estate is a bee farm. They raise the wretched little things for honey. It's owned by some smart-mouthed wood elf named Arangoth. We need you to teach him a lesson by burning down three of the estate's hives and clearing out the safe in the main house. The catch is that you can't burn the whole place to the ground. That important client Mercer mentioned would be furious if you did. Aye. The last thing we want to be doing is crossing our clients. Maven prefers that Arangoth remains alive, but if he tries to stop you from getting the job done, kill him. The Guild has a lot riding on this. Don't make me look foolish by mucking it up. They're built like small fortresses to resist the weather, but their one weakness is flame. Besides, nothing tells the people of Riften we mean business better than a huge column of smoke. I'll give you one good reason. Maven Blackbriar. Burn all the hives, and she'd have to import honey for Blackbriar Meadery, which would cut into her profits. We had an arrangement with Maven. We kept an eye on Golden Glow Estate to make sure the honey kept flowing. If the workers had a dispute, we'd rough them up. If competitors tried to buy honey from Arangoth, we'd steal the shipments. In return, Maven allowed us to extort Arangoth and bring in a huge payout. Let me put it to you this way. Nothing happens in Riften without Maven's consent. One word from her, and you could spend the rest of the Fourth Era in prison. Golden Glow Estate brought in a mountain of gold for the Guild. You could almost call it our sweetest deal. Then out of the clear blue, Arangoth stopped sending us our cut. Mercer was, well, angry to put it kindly. So we send in Vex and find out he's hired a bunch of mercenaries to guard the place. Aye. Arangoth sent the city guard packing and fortified the entire island. In fact, Vex barely made it out of there alive. You should talk to her about it before you go. You watch yourself on that island. Those mercenaries don't take prisoners.
Before we begin, I want to make two things perfectly clear. One, I'm the best infiltrator this rat hole of a guild's got. So if you think you're here to replace me, you're dead wrong. And two, you follow my lead and do exactly as I say. No questions, no excuses. Easy, huh?
So, should I just hand you purses of coin, or are you gonna work to earn your keep? Let me give you a small bit of advice. Nothing in this line of work is easy. If it was, every dragon the Ratway would be robbing Riften blind. If something's being handed to you on a silver platter, then there's a catch. Steal the platter instead. You get it? Then we understand each other. Good. Now, it's time to get your feet wet. And I don't want to waste a lot of time talking about anything but business. I'm not gonna sugarcoat it for you. We're in a bad way down here. Who knows? Old Delvin thinks it's some kind of curse. I think he's crazy. If you want my opinion, I'd say it's just plain old bad luck. You can get out there and start making a name for us again. Make them start fearing us like they did long ago. And while you're at it, make a little bit of coin on the side. Not a bad deal, eh? Yeah, I did. That wood elf's wit. He's a lot smarter than I expected. Can you believe that fetcher had more than tripled the guard? There must have been 8 of them in there. It was like he was daring us to come and get him. Well, there's an old sewer tunnel that dumps into the lake on the northwest side of the island. That's how I slipped in there. Should still be unguarded. Are you kidding me? Ever since the guild's luck turned sour, we haven't had a coin to our name. And when the coin dried up, that's when people started to leave. We had the best of everything down here. The Ratway was a damn palace. The only way this place will ever return to its glory days is if we can finish these extra jobs and start the gold flowing again. The Flagon was once a city beneath the city. We had our own smith, our own alchemist, you name it. If we can make a name for ourselves in Skyrim once again, I can almost promise you those merchants would return. Best of all, we'd have enough gold to throw around so we could start living in the lap of luxury again. If you're ever in need of some quick coin for items you find on the job, Tenelia is the best fence around. And besides myself, Delvin, Niruin, and Vipper can help you with any sort of training you might need to sharpen your skills. I handle the burglary, shill, sweep, and heist jobs. Most of them involve breaking and entering. If you don't like that kind of work, talk to Delvin. He runs the more up-close and personal jobs. Pretty simple. Break into a house, grab a specific item, and get out before they realize what's going on. The catch is you can't kill anyone who lives there, or you forfeit the payment. You ready for some good old-fashioned burglary? All right, take this and get out of here.
With your life, let me guess. He just plucked you off the street and dropped you into the thick of things without telling you which way is up. Am I right? Lying to my face isn't going to win you any favors with me. I can promise you that. On the other hand, taking some of these extra jobs off my hands. Now, that'll get you to the top of my list. See, that kind of attitude comes from someone who wants to get rich and stay alive long enough to enjoy it. We're gonna get along nicely. So, if you've got the nerve, I've got plenty of extra jobs to help get the guild back on its feet. Look around you. The Flagon, the guild, it's all falling apart. A few decades ago, this place was as busy as the Imperial City. Now, you'd be lucky if you don't trip over a skeever instead. Look, I know the others think I'm a bit daft for saying stuff like this, but I'm gonna give it you straight. Something out there is piss drunk mad at us. I don't know who or what it is, but it's beyond just you and me. We've been cursed. I'll tell you what we do. We spit in that curse's face and turn things around down here. Put things back the way they were. That's where you come in. I've got plenty of work available that could guide us down the road to recovery. All you need to do is ask, and we can both come out of this smelling like a rose. Watch yourself out there. The mercenaries are in Gough Hire to train killers. Just ask our poor little Vex. If you're looking to get some coin for the fruits of your labor, you should talk to Tenelia. She sounds tough, but she'll cut you a fair deal. I also suggest you spend some time in the training room. Just talk to Vipper. He'll show you around. Years ago, the Guild used to have a foothold in every major city in Skyrim. You wouldn't dare even lift an apple without checking with us. When things started going downhill around here, it became difficult to keep it all together. We lost fences, influential contacts, and coin. It wasn't long before we lost what we depend on to survive. Respect. By doing these extra jobs and putting some fear into the people, we can take back the cities and start being taken seriously once again. Thanks to Maven Blackbriar, we still have some pull in Riften. But get arrested in Whiterun, and you'll be tossed right into the prisons. If we gain the confidence of someone very influential who lives there by doing a unique job for them, we'll be able to have some leverage there too. The only way we get that special job is by doing smaller ones in those cities until we catch their ear. Then, they'll contact me, and we're off. I handle the fishing, numbers, and bedlam jobs. The ones with a more personal touch. If break-ins are more your thing, go talk to Vex. Most of the establishments in Skyrim keep their transactions recorded within business ledgers. Your job will be to change the numbers in those books so the shortfalls from our other jobs look legit. Feel like doing a bit of writing? Here's everything you need. You get caught, but we've never heard of you. Pull up a seat. Have a drink.
So you're the new recruit, huh? I'm the fence down here. You come by anything you don't exactly own, and I'll pay you some coin for it. Minus a little slice for the guild, of course. I can also provide a few supplies useful to our trade now and again, for a small fee. Sure, how about I get Dirge to knock you over your head and dump you into the cistern? Look, I've been in this business a long time, and I've seen all types. You can play it tough, or you can play it smart. Whatever. At the end of the day, you'll find that all we care about down here is how much gold you can make us. Good. Then there isn't much more to say. Here's your armor. Just make sure you put it to good use. Mm-hmm.